from Axtell, Kansas. Looks like he is going to be the very first one to come out in the spare parts. That's starting off originally as a Case 930. 504, Case motor, underneath the cowling. Terry has owned and pulled this tractor every year since 1980, so he's got a pretty long run of being able to pull it year by year, Terry Stallbaumer, and the guy's not very old. Retirement age, getting the AARP mail, that's for sure. Terry's been married 43 years to Norma, 5 children, living in his son Shannon also pulls in a tractor, the Limited Pro Super Farm class, drives the Justin Case tractor. Shannon is married, 3 children, so very proud grandpa and Terry as he gets ready to bring his rod up and hook to the X-Factor, the Bumgarten Motorsports sled. 50,000 pounds of dead weight sitting there as that weight transfer box comes forward. Turns into 250,000 pounds of dead weight on downforce, wheel standing. Case tractor. No-cut tires, limited to 466 cubic inches. And the 3LM turbo's got to be mowed on the stocks, and we're going to get an official distance here on the spare parts tractor entry as we get down track. When we get going into some of our other classes, we'll tell you a little bit more about the ins and outs, news and notes of the NHRDA sled calling, like the fact that there is no practice, there is no qualifying. It is a one-and-done deal. There are two caveats to that one-and-done deal. That means there are two things that could happen that would give you a second try at it. One of those things is being able to get the sled stopped before the 100-foot mark. Some associations, it is 75 feet, but here at the NHRDA, it is 100 feet. So if you're able to get stopped by 100 feet, you go back and re-pull. You go back and re-hook. But that is a one chance only on being able to stop before the 100. The other caveat, the only other time you get more than one hook on the sled is if you are first in class and you deny the pull. You say that you didn't feel that the sled was properly set for your class. First in class does have first right of refusal. If they say they didn't like the hook, normally some associations, you'd come back in the fifth place in pull order. At the NHRDA, typically they go to the very tail end of the field. And to me, when you've got a big class, let's say you roll into a class with 20 pulls in it, 20 hooks are coming up in your class, and you're first out, you don't like the hook, you turn it away, that means you're going to be the 21st hook of that class coming into the last place. One thing it does do is give you an opportunity to know what you need to beat, and all know that the track crew, Carl and his guys, do a great job of maintaining and prepping the surface of that 300 feet of fun between each hook. Still, when you get that many vehicles in class, a line starts to develop. It might get soft in a couple of spots, or a line that was nice, solid, and firm when you went down as number one might not be there as number 21, and you line up in that lane and in that line that is no longer any good. So right now, we got a lot to think about as the racers are getting themselves prepared for tonight's event. Give you a rundown of more of the stuff, the activities, the things that are going on per class. As it looks like we got a little bit of help coming up from the cat storm. Looks like the front end got augered down on the Bumgarten Motorsports sled. The X-Factor, get a little bit of help from the skid steer. So coming in behind the skid steer, you see the skid steer not only on the bucket that was just helping.